Welcome back to Learner's Academy. I'm Mona Bhatia, and the poem that I have chosen today is The Road Not Taken. It's basically about the decisions that we make in life. It is the moment of decisions that our destiny is shaped. And this beautiful poem is written by Robert Frost. So it tells us about we are what we choose to be. Now let's go to the poem. The Road Not Taken, the poet begins describing a point in life when reached a place where the road he was traveling suddenly diverges into two. He's standing at the fork in a forest with the yellow leaves. Here we see the poet has tried to use symbolism. The description of yellow wood indicates the autumn season. Which is a period of transition in man's life. It's a transition from adolescence to adulthood, or even it can be taken as a difficult phase of life where we need to decide. So I'm going to take up each line. The two roads diverged in a yellow wood. The poet felt sorry, and sorry I could not travel both. The poet felt sorry that he had to choose one and could not travel on both the roads. We can relate this as to how we face dilemma when we have to make choices in our life, and it is really difficult to zero in on one choice, you know. And be one traveler long I stood. So that means he stood there analyzing the situation, and like any other traveler, he took long time to make up his mind and peers down the road. And look down on one as far as I could. So he peers down the road till the place where it bends and is covered with to where it bent in the undergrowth. Undergrowth means a dense growth of shrubs under the trees. Alright. So he tries to see as far as he could. Alright. And he peers down the road till the place where it bends and is covered with bushes. In real life situation also, when we are at such a junction where we have to make a choice, we try to analyze and see the various possibility to some extent that we would have to go through in case we choose a certain path. After that, it bends in the undergrowth. After that, it is not possible to see what would happen in the future. Means it will be lost in the future. We are not sure what would be the outcome of our choices that we are taking right now. He took the other just as fair. He chose the road, the one road which was less used by others. So because it was grassy and wanted wear means it was not used by others. All right. And better claims means it was more interesting than the others. All right. So it is made clear when he says because it was grassy and wanted. It was grassy. It was not used by others. So it wanted some wear. It needed to be used by others. He thought this road was also as fair as the other one, and says it had better claim because he was not following the crowd. And he was pursuing something that is rare and different, which was more interesting. Better claim means more interesting. So though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Now we move on to the third stanza. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden back. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. But as he walked further down the road, he realized it was equally traveled by others. All right, that morning both the road seemed equally covered with leaves, and that had not been blackened by the footsteps of the people. Oh, I kept the first for another day. He wished to travel the other one too, but he also was aware that how one way leads to the other, so he was very doubtful of ever coming back. All right, So we'll move on to the fourth stanza. I shall be telling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence. So he concludes with a sigh. He's not happy. He says that in future he might tell about this with a sigh, means with disappointment, many many years later, that when two roads went in different direction in a world, that means in the dark future. Here, two roads when diverge in woods, that means two roads in a dark future. He took the one less traveled by, which made all the difference. So the final line conveys the feeling of a person when he's not sure whether the decision taken by him will have a positive impact or a negative impact on his future. Whenever you will reach a future, because of the decision that we make or the choices we make in our life, your decision leads your life. Life is all about making the right choices. See, sometime you make the right decision, sometime you make the decision right, you work on it. Whatever decision that you have taken, you have to work on it to make it sound right. All right? And decision are the hardest thing to make, especially when it is a choice between where you should be and where you want to be. All right, now we'll go to the next topic. Now, to have a better understanding of the poem, we'll have some questions. Why does the poet feel sorry? The poet felt sorry because he was not able to travel on both the roads. It's not easy to travel to have your feet on both the road. Did the poet choose the road quickly? No, he didn't choose the road quickly because he took time. He stood there at the fork like any other traveler, and he was trying to analyze the situation. If we choose this one, what would happen? And if we choose the other one, what would be the outcome? So he took some time. All right. Was one of the road better than the other? No. Apparently, both the roads were equally good because he has used one line, then he took the other as just as fair. So he took the one which was less used by others, but he was th that road was as fair as the other. So he has not mentioned that the other road was better than the other. Does the poet tell us what difference it made? No. The poet doesn't state clearly what difference it makes, but it happens in our life when we have already made the choices, and when we look down the ages after certain times, we are happy with whatever decision we have made in our future, in our past, because we can't change it now. So the poet here also says that has made all the difference because now he's happy with whatever he is or wherever he is. Figures of speech for the poem, The Road Not Taken. The very first line states this poem is an extended metaphor, and the two roads diverging, okay, stands for the choices we have in our life. Road is a metaphor for life. Diverged is a metaphor for choice. And yellow wood is a metaphor for making choices during the hard time. Yellow wood is a metaphor for hard times. So there is a hidden metaphor in the form of choices that poet has to make. All right. Now we move on to the next figure of speech. Then took the other as just as fair. Here there is a simile. It shows how the poet has linked the road less taken to the easy way through life. All right. And having perhaps the better claim. I have underlined this line because there is an inversion here. The correct prose order should have been "and perhaps having the better claim." In the next line, you can see there is a alliteration. The letter W is repeated for better poetic effect, and also there is a personification Because the road has been personified, all right, as if road is human and it wanted to be used because it was grassy and wanted wear. It wanted the road wanted to be used as if it is a human being. Now in the next line there is again alliteration. The sound of the is repeated in this line. The consonant sound the is repeated. TH makes the sound the. And then we move on to this line. And both that morning equally lay. There is another inversion here, and the correct prose order should have been, and that morning both equally lay in leaves. So these two lines have to be taken till here because the meaning is complete here. Okay, and the next one I have highlighted in bold. Oh, I kept the first for another day. There is an exclamation in this sentence. Exclamation means when strong feelings are expressed in the nature of an exclamation mark. The figure of speech is exclamation. All right, the next line has a repetition. The word way is repeated here. All right, and then you can see there is another repetition in this line. Ages, the word ages is repeated for better poetic effect and to emphasize the word. All right, that's all about the figures of speech in this poem. Critical appreciation of the poem. The title of the poem is The Road Not Taken. The poet is Robert Frost, and he's an American poet. And Fire and Ice is another one of his pioneering work and my favorite. Rhyme scheme of the poem is ABAAB. All right, and then we come to the next topic, figures of speech. The poet has used symbolism in order to bring out the message beautifully. The description of yellow wood is indicates the autumn season, which is like a period of transition or adolescence in one's life, where people face dilemma of choosing the best option or for them. Autumn yellow wood also stands for the difficult phase in life where we need to take a decision. And this poem is an extended metaphor. The two roads diverge stands for the choices that we have to make in our life. So apart from symbolism and metaphor, the poem also has inversion and having perhaps the better claim. This is an example of inversion and also repetition, yet knowing how way leads to the way. So the word way is repeated somewhere, ages and ages, so the word ages is repeated. All right, so basically it is repeated to emphasize something. Now we move on to the central idea of the poem. The central idea of the poem is that there is a conflict in the mind of a person who is at the junction of choosing between two options. It is very difficult decision because once you opt for your choice, there is no coming back. Decisions are the hardest to make, especially during adolescent and especially during the hard times. And it is symbolically represented by autumn in the poem, yellow woods. Alright, now why I like this poem? I like this poem as it encourages me not to be afraid to take the road which is less traveled by. And this poem is a great read. I too would choose the less trodden path so that I can find something new, as I want to be a trendsetter. You know, I know there might be difficulties and trouble down the road. The famous sea explorers were able to find new lands because they accepted the challenges of traveling into the unsailed sea. And nothing new can be discovered if you tread the old, same very old and used path. So this way I like this poem because the poet is encouraging me to choose the one which is less used by others. That's all about the poem. Keep watching Learners Academy and keep sharing these videos with your friends, because sharing is caring and it always helps to increase knowledge and share with others. Thank you very much.